Yadavya from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in Department of Electronics and Communication. Today we will discuss the subject that is Python programming, and in Python programming we will discuss the experiment, or we can say the programs that is related to MicroPython. The first is how to blink the LED, that is using ESP8266. See, as we discussed in our last video lecture, see, there are many boards available. That is, for example, ESP8266, then it's ESP32, Pi board. You can take any board. But right now we are doing the experiment that is based on the ESP8266. And we are going to blink the, that is, inbuilt LED. If you want to connect any external LED, that is also possible. And then the second is what? To interface the IR sensor, that is using the MicroPython. So we are going to use the two board, that is, one is the IR sensor board and another is what is the ESP8266. And then we are writing one switch program, right? That means if the switch is pressed, that means what? The LED that will be blink. Alright, so let's start our today's practical session. So first we will start to blink the LED, that is using the board, that is ESP8266 board. Then this is the board, right? This is ESP8266 board, and here you can see this is what is a power cable, and the theory related to this board that already we have explained in our earlier video. So first of all, what I have to do, I have to connect one power cable, or we can say it's a simple USB cable or charging cable to this board. So right now I'm just connecting this simple USB cable to this board right here. So this is connected. Now what you have to do, the next step is you have to open the UPI craft, that is version 1.1, and already we discussed where you can download this version. Okay, so first of all I'm just writing, already I have downloaded that. So this is what I want to open. This is UPI craft version 1.1. this is the UCraft. Okay, now here already we have discussed this section. This section is what is a files and folder. So whatever the files that you are writing, for example, see here I have some file that is already written, that is in my workspace, and then here you have a SD. Okay, that is what is a memory card, you can say something like that. And then here this is what, this is your editor window where you can write the code. And here this is what, it's a tool, that means here this button, that is for the run the download and run the code, and this is for the save the program, like that. Okay, so this is the different buttons available here. And here in this section you can see the output of your code. If any error is there, then this will display over here. All right, so now next, see here you have to select the COM port. Here it's a COM3. And if you have not installed your driver properly, then you are not able to see this COM3. For example, see here how you can check whether the driver is properly installed or not. Then you just go to the device manager. Here, in a device manager, see here ports are there. Okay. In a port, see, this is the port. Already we have discussed this in our theory part. Right, when you install the driver, then Silicon Lab CP210 USB to UART bridge, this port will activate. Now here what I'll do, simple, I have to write one code. So to write a code, you just select file, new and untitled. Now what do we want to do? We want to blink the LED. So now first of all I want to import the module. That module is what? It's a time module. So I'm just writing, this is what is an import, and then my module name is what is a time module. I want this module because I want some on off time. See, in a Python, see MicroPython, you cannot use each and every module that is available in a Python. So this is the main difference between the Python and MicroPython, because here you have to work in a some constrained environment. But this time module is available in a both, that is Python as well as in a MicroPython. Now the next word, I want to send and receive the some signals to the pin number of this particular board. So I'm just using that is from machine. From this machine, I want to import that is what it's a pin number. So from using this module, I can send and receive the particular high and low signals. Now next, here I'm just going to specify a one variable. That variable is what? LED. And yes, here we are going to on and off, that is inbuilt LED that is present in this board. All right, if you want to connect this into the, for example, if you want to connect the external LED, that also possible. Right, so for that you have to connect one LED and registers in a breadboard, and then you have to take out these two wires from this board, and then you have to connect with that with the breadboard. Now here we are just using LED, that is what pin, and pin number I'm just using the two number. For that you have to refer the GPIO pin, right, and that is already we have discussed in our theory part. So it's a 2 comma pin dot out. All right, now next what we want to do, we want to execute one loop, and that loop is always true. All right, then what I'll do, I will send some high signal some particular time, and then I will send some low signal. So I'm just using the command that is what is LED, because we want to send the signal to pin number 2, and that is assigned inside the variable, that is what is LED. Then its value, that is what, for example, I'm using that is high, so that is what is a 1. Then what I have to decide, that is here LED, sorry, it's a time. I have to decide the time, that is time slip, and then the time is what, for example, I'm using 0.5. So I want this value for 0.5. Now again I'm using that is LED dot, it's a value, and it's what, it's a 0, and for that the time is what, I'm using the time dot slip, and this again the time is what, it's a 0.5. So this is a very simple and basic program to on off the LED that is present inside the board, right? So next what you have to do, first of all you have to save this file. So save, and I'm just giving the file name, that is for example is on off, then it's okay. Here also you can use this button also. Now you just run this code. Here before that you have to see this is COM3 selected, and then here board, see these are the board that is available. One is the ESP8266, then ESP32, Pi board, right? So whatever the board you are using, that you have to select from this list. So right now it is ESP8266. Now let's run this code. Now here see, ready to download this file. Wait, download is okay. As such, we are not getting any error. And here you can see in this board, see the LED is on off, on off. So this is a simple program which you can use to blink the LED that is present in this board, that is ESP8266 board. Now for example, if you are getting any error, that is a COM port is not open, yeah, please select the COM port, yeah, error that is related to COM port, then what you have to do, I'll just show this. Here in a tool, you have to go in a download, this is the firmware. Burn the firmware. Here you just select your ESP8266, erase the flash and the COM3, then users. And here you have to select the bin file that is we have downloaded earlier. Then choose, and for example, my bin file is there in the download, and here I have to select the bin file, this bin file. And then you have to press the button OK, and then you have to press this button, flash button. Okay, and then you have to press the okay. This is the erase the flash. Okay, if you have to do this step whenever you are getting any error that is related to COM port, otherwise that is all right. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now next, what we want to do, we want to interface the IR sensor with this board. So for that, I'm just using the one module of IR sensor. So here, first of all, what we will do? Here only I'm just writing the code, okay? So here, this is the module I will use. Here also there are the three pin. That is what? It's a VCC, ground and output. So you have to connect this with this board, particular board. How you can connect? So here also that is written, that is ground, VCC, okay, and out. And here also written. So you have to see here, this is already mentioned. So right now I'm just connecting this two particular board. So for that, now here we will write the code that is related to interfacing the IR sensor, ESP32 and it's ESP8266 and then our MicroPython. So the what we will do, your first line that we are writing, that is we want to import, right? Because we want to send and receive the signal. So machine, we want to import what? It's a pin. Now the next, that is here we have to specify the pin number, that what we have done in our earlier code, that is LED. Then here I'm just writing pin and then it's a 2 comma, that is pin dot, it's a out. So I'm just specifying that pin as a what? It's an output pin. Then next I'm just writing the button, that is another variable. Just I'm taking that variable as name of that variable is what? It's a button. Then here I'm just using the pin and here I'm just writing that is 14. Then it's a pin dot in comma, it's a pin dot pull up, right? Because you have to specify the input pin also. So that statement I'm just writing. The next bit we are writing, that is what? It's a loop, that is while, that is always true, because we want to execute this loop every time. So that is what? It's always true. Now inside that I'm just writing if not button, okay, if the button is not pressed, then what do you have to write? That is LED that equal to what? It's a not LED. So whatever this status, that is if it is on, then it will become off. It is off, then it will become on. Now next, here we have to specify, that is while not button while loop, that is not button like this. Then next what we will write here, that is pass. Simply what we want to do, we want to pass this. So this is what is a simple code, right? Here we are not using any switch, just I'll show you how we can run this code. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to save this. Then here you have to open this, already this COM3 is open, this is all right. And then we have to what? We have to run this code. So ready to download, download is open, everything is fine. Then I'll show you. See here we are getting one error, that is what? In line number 1, it's a module error, and in line number 6, here I have to mention that is not, then space, and then it's a LED. Now let's run this. Let's see, is there any error? No, such there is no error. Now here, how I can show you? See, this is my two board. This is what is the IR sensor, and this is my ESP8266. See here, now the LED is off. Now again, this will become LED is what? It's on. So here, when you apply this, then here, LED is on. Now, if I say, see the LED is off. Now again, see the LED is on. So whatever the status is there, if it is on, then again, it will become what? It's off. So here just I am doing manually. If you want to operate that with the switch, then you can easily interface the switch with this. The code will remain same. So I hope this session is clear. If you have any doubt, then please let me know. Thank you.